yourself a Merry Little Christmas. Make the old I gave from.
Welcome back, everyone, to part two of our Christmas series. Tis the season, according to Jarett. Happy Festivus. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. Good to have you guys back. We got a few more Christmas topics. I didn't feel like we quite finished everything up. Have you guys finished, by the way, have you finished your Christmas shopping yet?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I didn't do much of it. I left it to my wife, which I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but she did most of it.
Rusty, before the show, you were saying that you were calling Jarett's wife a rookie. Jarett, you didn't hear this.
No, he
was calling your wife a rookie because you had to go give her your credit card number. Rusty says, rookie, my wife knows my credit card number off the top of her head.
She has it memorized, which is not good. I was buying something for myself once online, and I go to get my wallet, and she's like, she just starts rattling off the number. And I'm just like, how the hell did we get to this place right now? Like, what in the world?
I don't even remember my own credit card information.
Yeah, me either. It's always in my wallet.
Yeah.
So you're both done shopping?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I've been done for maybe about a week and a half.
Wow. From what I've read, about 2/3 of Americans actually shop the week leading up to Christmas. So it's a country of procrastinators.
Is it because there's deals, or they just wait?
I guess it's just putting it off. I mean, you guys are the minority. It sounds like you've been done for a while.
It is a busy time of year. There's a lot going on.
And I'm always the person that thinks about other people. Like, I think about, like, Amazon workers. I'm like, I should just get it done, and then they don't have to worry about me, instead of doing it and then trying to do it, like, a few days before, and just, like, having, like, express shipment. And then it's just like, man, I'm just putting more work on them if I do that, if I'm start shopping the 21st or 22nd. Like, let me get it done, and then they don't have to worry about me. I don't know why my brain works like that.
Then you get my wife memorizing my debit card and is like, screw it. They can just work every freaking day an hour. Bye, 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 bye. Just kidding, babe. Kind of.
So curious, there's a couple of things that we were chatting about on Christmas. Best Christmas gift or best Christmas memory? They could be tied together. Is there anything that stands out for you guys?
Go ahead, Rusty.
I got a couple, and they're not like they're not crazy, but I guess the time that I finally realized that Santa maybe wasn't real. So it was, you guys will remember this time. So in 64, Nintendo 64 had come out, and they had Cruisin' USA at the bowling alley. And that was like the game. Everybody wanted to play it. And so that game finally came out on Nintendo 64. So we asked for that for Christmas. And I remember waking up and there's this handwritten note under the tree. And I'm like, what is this? And it's from Santa saying, sorry, couldn't find Cruisin' USA for you, but I promise I'll get it to you as soon as I can. And it was in my mom's handwriting.
Well, what probably happened was she saw Santa that night. Santa doesn't have time to write notes for everyone. Probably saw your mom, told her what was up. She wrote the note then, and then Santa popped out and left.
Yep.
You're probably right. He's real. What was I thinking?
Jarett, anything? Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I remember one memory stands out, and it was when Xbox was released. And I remember it was released. It had been out for a while. And so I remember I asked mom and dad, I was like, look, I want nothing else. Don't get me anything else for Christmas. And this has been going on for a few years. I've been asking just for one thing. So I was like, hey, just give me this, and I'll be happy. So, and they're like, okay, yeah, well, that's what we'll do. And I remember a few months before Christmas, my dad just bought a new grill. And I remember looking at it. I'm like, oh, looks like I'm not getting an Xbox. And I'm just like, and I remember thinking, it's like, I just want one thing. Like, I don't want anything else. And so Christmas morning rolls around and we're all opening our presents. And once again, you know, there's opening gifts. And I'm like, I'm a little disappointed because I just want one thing. Like, you didn't need to do anything else. Like, this is too much. This is too much. I didn't ask for any of this. It's like, and my parents have always done that. So anyway, very last present, my mom gives a present to my dad. He opens it up and he's like, what am I going to do with these? And then of course it doesn't really click for us. It's like, so we kind of look at him. It's just like, I was like, I don't know what to do with these. And so I go up and look, and what it is, it's two Xbox games. It's Madden 2002 and it's Project Gotham Racing. That's and we're awesome. Like, what? And they said, all right, it's somewhere in the house. Good luck finding it. And so, we looked everywhere, and it was in my parents' closet, and we were so excited. We hooked it up, and oh my gosh, I think I played Madden all day.
It was that's a cool story. I love how they like tricked you too.
Yeah. And like I said, it's the only thing I wanted. It was an awesome surprise. And how they played it off, and yeah, it was. For some reason that always sticks in my mind, and it'll always be a memory that I'll never forget.
Cool,
it's cool.
So
I did end up getting Cruising USA.
Oh, okay.
Santa brought it a couple months later. We did get it.
Good.
We played the heck out of that.
He held to his promise.
He did. The other one I had was, and I don't even remember this. This is a story my parents have to tell me because I was pretty young. I got my first Power Wheels, and it was under the tree. Like when we came out that morning, and my mom says I jumped in that thing. They left the keys in it because you had to turn the key, and then it was on. And I hit the gas pedal, and it was in reverse, and I ran over the Christmas tree. Yeah, demolished the Christmas tree. And then later they take me outside. They're like, oh, we'll let them do it outside. I backed up and like put a huge dent in the garage door. Like it was just a disaster.
Oh, man. Your driving record has not changed since.
Hey, I've only been on a few accidents.
So how old were you when this happened?
I don't know. I had my driver's license.
Yeah.
So I'm curious, have you guys ever gotten a gift that you didn't like? And what do you do?
We kept it.
It's so tough. Were you opening it in front of the person who gave it to you?
Yes. Yes. It was my mom and dad. And we were all I'm 27 28 at the time. Jason's 27 and Jeff's in his 30s. Okay, so Christmas morning rolls around, we all get a box. So we open up the box and it's remote control helicopters.
That's cool.
Yeah,
I what am I gonna do with a remote control helicopter?
Fly it around. I'll take it.
Yeah. Well, I broke it pretty much instantly because we didn't know how to. And they were just. They said they were in the mall in Manhattan. Saw these things. I'm like, oh, the boys will like them. And I'm just like, see, that's the thing. Is it's like I never asked for remote control helicopters.
When your mom listens to this, this going to be the first time that she finds out you didn't like that helicopter?
No. Okay. This will not be the first time.
You tell her immediately. You're just like, what the hell is this?
I laughed. I was just like,
wait. Did you laugh more for this gift or more for Christmas vacation?
The helicopter.
Wow. Oh my god.
The helicopter. Now, once again, it wasn't like I was some spoiled brat. And I opened this like, oh, what is this? I'm not gonna need this. You still put on that face like, oh, awesome. Thank you very much. And then
something tells me you're not the best actor.
Oh, I'm not. Oh, absolutely. Oh, I can attest to that. I'm terrible. I'm an awful actor. But I think a few months later, I did tell them, as it's like, hey, you guys didn't need, like, that probably wasn't the best decision to do remote control helicopters. Like, I sound like such a Grinch right now. And that's not how I wanted to sound.
You're a mean one.
There are kids in Africa that would love those remote controlled helicopters.
There's kids here.
Yeah, there's kids here in America that would love them.
True. I want one that remote-controlled helicopter. Jarett, this reminds me, I almost bought you something for Christmas this year.
So, I hope it didn't have a remote control.
I saw something in Target, and I was like, oh my God, I have to get this for Jarett. It was a pillow that was a cheese puff bag, and inside the pillow were little cheese, like, little miniature cheese puffs. I literally had it in my arms, picked it up, was gonna go purchase it. I scanned it. It was $40. I was like, man, I don't blame you. Sorry, Jarett. If it was like $12.99 or less, which was kind of what I was thinking it might be, I was like, oh yeah, he's getting this.
Yeah, well, I haven't bought anything for you at all for, so. My grandma, my mom's side, every single year, package of Oreos for Christmas.
A package of Oreos for Christmas.
Every single
year. That's a good gift.
Yeah.
Like, who doesn't want a package of Oreos?
Well, it's funny. I get it. Ha, ha, ha. But after year 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, it's like, okay, we all get it. I love Oreos, but let's not go overboard. It's like, I get the jokes. The joke's good. But, and the thing is, it got a laugh every year at Christmas. I'm like, how are we not all expecting this? How are we not all expecting what I'm holding in my hand right now?
Running joke.
Oh my God.
Was it the same? Was it the same original Oreo, or is it different flavors?
Oh, it was double stuff every year.
Double stuff every year.
It was double stuff.
So is that like the weirdest, strangest gift you've ever gotten?
No, it is not.
Oh my God.
Oh man. It had to have been. 2 years ago, two years ago, my grandma was giving out prank gifts, basically. And most of the time it was like squash, a potato, maybe like a squishy lemon. And it was just like, and she played it off like, Merry Christmas. I'm like, thanks, Grandma.
Did you get a normal gift and this prank gift, or was the prank gift your gift?
The prank gift was like a potato, and then the real gift was, well, lo and behold, it was Oreos.
I don't think I've ever gotten something as weird as a potato. I can't think of anything weird. I can tell you, I do have a story though. We were doing our family Christmas with Courtney's family a couple years back, and Courtney's mom always gives us stockings, and there's usually the scratch-off lottery tickets in there. Right. She'd get like 5 to 10 for everybody. So we're doing it at our house 1 year, and Courtney's brother, who I don't know, he was maybe 12, 13 at the time. I knew this beforehand, but her mom gave him one of the prank ones that says you've won like $10,000.
Oh, that's mean.
And he scratched it off. And he was going nuts and, you know, just so excited. Oh, that's mean. And then he looked at the back and finally figured out it was fake. And it was devastation afterwards. It was so bad.
There would be about a minute of like, just like absolute pure disappointment.
I know what you'd buy with $10,000. A remote controlled helicopter.
I would buy 5,000 remote control helicopters. And then just give them to homeless people. I'm like, here you go. Now you know what it's like for me every Christmas. I know this is not what you really wanted, but hey, it's going to be fun. Oh,
did you ever get anything weird for?
I think the weirdest thing I've ever gotten was a prank gift, and it was meant to be that. It was bacon deodorant. And I've never used it, and I've kind of had an exchange back and forth with my neighbor for the last 2 years, where we've just given it to each other back and forth for like Christmas or birthdays. And I just delivered it last night to him. So so I've got a list of this or that's for us to buzz through. and curious to see kind of your thoughts on that. Similar topics to kind of what we've discussed a little bit. White elephant or secret Santa? First off, what's the difference? Is white elephant basically a gag gift? Secret Santa is you get something nice, but you don't know who it's from?
White elephant. It's the first person gets to open a gift. The next person can either take that person's gift or open another one. And then so like the last person truly is the best because they can have whatever gift.
Whatever they want. Yeah.
It's terrible. It's terrible.
Because you never end up with what you want.
Exactly.
And like everyone's mad. So yes. I'm voting Secret Santa on this all day long.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I would take Secret Santa. And I thought white elephant is you don't know who you're buying for. You just like there's like a price range of like $35 and then you just buy something.
And then, often they're gag gifts like bacon deodorant.
I'm with you. I'm Secret Santa all the way. I'm not a white elephant guy.
All right, so that one's easy. I think this next one's easy too. Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays?
Merry freaking Christmas.
Yes, Merry Christmas.
Has to be.
Yeah. Do you know anybody that's ever got like real life? Has anybody that you ever have known got offended because of Merry Christmas?
I can't say, but maybe they haven't spoken up about it. I don't have a ton of examples, but my old manager is Jewish, and he always said, look, I'm more than happy to celebrate Christmas, like especially if you want to give me gifts.
Yeah,
they get even more gifts. They get like a gift every day for like 2 weeks.
Yeah. Isn't it 8 days? Yeah. Eight days of Hanukkah? We get eight crazy nights. I didn't think of the Adam Sandler song. I think it's eight. Merry Christmas.
You're right. It's eight crazy nights.
Yeah.
Adam Sandler has educated me a lot about Hanukkah.
He does. Absolutely. Yeah. And you know all the Jewish people in Hollywood. So
I remember something about a dreidel. I don't know exactly, but
yep. You spin it and then that means that Jesus won't see his shadow for 3 weeks. And then that means like three more weeks of Christmas. I think. I don't know. My Jewish holidays are.
Did you mix that up with the groundhog?
No, I don't think so.
I think he's right. I think he's right.
Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, don't look it up. Just assume that that's what that happens.
We are not experts.
Yeah, we're not experts. I'm not claiming to be an expert on the Jewish holiday festival, but I think that's what it is. You spend the dreidel and then you like hide the eggs, and then Jesus like comes back and he like sees a shadow. And then it's like three more weeks of Christmas. So
if he doesn't see a shadow, then it becomes Festivus.
You know, who really knows? I mean, it's ridiculous.
I don't know. So many people.
And then they celebrate if he does see a shadow by throwing peas at each other. So I think that's what happens.
No, that is literally the most inclusive holiday I think I've ever had in my life.
I want to be Jewish.
No, this was everything. Yeah. This was everything. Every tradition and holiday was baked into that.
Yep,
it was.
Except for the throwing of the peas. I don't know what holiday that is.
And then they end it with watching Die Hard. Boom.
Boom. There you go.
So curious, receive or give a gift?
Oh, give.
For sure. You got to be a jerk to say receive, right? Who's going to say that? I can't wait to put that poll out because whoever puts receive, it'll be Big John. It will be Big John.
Big John is going to want to receive a gift. So just go ahead and tally your vote now, Big John.
Yeah, just count it up, Big John. Receive gifts. So
no doubt.
Speaking of giving gifts, are either of you giving your wives a Peloton for Christmas this year?
No. And did anybody look up how expensive those things are?
Like $2,000.
Rusty guessed $2,000.
Yeah. Like,
but can't you do, like, can't you actually ride any basically course or highway or trail in the world and it adjusts to the difficulty and whatnot as you're riding it? I mean, that's pretty cool.
$2,300 seems a little steep for everything.
My wife's pregnant too. That'd be a pretty terrible gift to give right about now. Just a guess.
What if she wanted one?
That'd be different then.
Okay, well, and that's what happened in the Peloton commercial, people.
Did she want one?
She did. Did you see? I rewatched it after our episode. She is so excited. She's like posting selfies on social media and like thoroughly excited about the gift.
This is true. Yep. Because at the end of the year, they sat together and watched her little highlight video that she made herself.
They did.
Because he wants to see the work that she put in.
Fur, would you buy your wife a Peloton if she wanted one?
Well, if they had a sale.
Yeah, I knew that was happening. If it's like 50% off, sure.
Christmas tree decoration, classic ornaments, or unique custom ornaments?
I like, we use both, but I like the unique. Like, we always get like one ornament each year and just keep adding it to the tree each year.
I love that. Like, I love that too. I'm with you on the classic unique ornaments. My wife is against it. It's got to be the traditional, I guess maybe Home Alone style, like the round walls.
I'm more of a unique ornament person.
So we all agree.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want more of those ones that you plug into the light and like a little action happens.
I love those. I love those. Do those still work? I wonder if those work on LED lights though, because back in the day, LED didn't exist. So I wonder if they still work with like the new LED lights. On to another topic. White lights or colored lights?
Colored.
I think the white lights look prettier. Like if you're going for just like a pretty tree, white just looks, I guess, I don't know.
What about outside on a house?
I like the colors. I want colors outside.
Okay. I'm a color fan for both.
Yeah, I'm colors for both. It's just, it's Christmas. You're supposed to spice it up. Lots of colors and motions and the lights flicker on and off and they kind of go around the house and not white lights.
Yeah, I'm wondering if white is maybe the more like old school traditional, like classic. It's a classic.
Yeah.
And it also just kind of has more of a soft, I don't know, subtle feel to it.
It's not in your face.
White can look good if it's done right, I think. Yeah. But I prefer colored as well. Christmas Eve or Christmas Day, which do you like opening presents on?
Oh. Christmas Day.
We used to like every now and then open one on Christmas Eve, which is kind of fun.
Yes.
But the majority of them has to be on Christmas Day.
Yeah, I agree. I like the one though on Christmas Eve. Kind of like spice it up, spread it out a little bit.
We never did that. We never did a Christmas Eve opening one gift. It was always Christmas Day.
Because they didn't want to ruin your Christmas with giving you remote control helicopters Christmas Eve.
Yeah. What way to start off Christmas by opening up a gift? I'm like, oh, gosh darn it.
Yeah, I don't even want to wake up tomorrow.
Yeah, it's like, I'm all just sleep in till 7 a.m. I'm going to do this baloney. On Christmas morning, did your parents ever just purposely waste time?
Oh yeah.
Did you obviously wake up and then they just also woke up like, well, let me get some coffee first. Well, let me have a bowl of cereal or like, let me take a shower beforehand. Did they ever do that when you were kids?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Like that would be out of all the days out of the year, that'd be the only day. And I think I was the worst one that I would wake up like at 6 a.m. I'd be ready to go. I'm like, let's do this. Let's get this going. And I know for a fact, my mom and dad, they would wake up every day at 5 a.m. except for Christmas. And then all of a sudden they wake up at 7, like, well, let me get some coffee first. And like, mom's like, well, I'm going to take a shower first, and then I'm going to do my hair. And then I'm like, why? We're the only ones here. Let's get this going. But it's just I remember every single year, one day out of the year, they would not wake up early. And they would just take their time. And it drove me crazy.
Do you like Christmas?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I'm just curious. I couldn't tell.
I love Christmas. No, I love Christmas, man. And we had the discussion when we played Christmas music. I was like, hey, day after Thanksgiving, let's get this going. You know, let's get the holiday spirit going. I could listen I could listen to classical Christmas music every single day of the year, and it would never get old.
Real or artificial Christmas tree?
Artificial.
Yeah. There's too many hazards with the real Christmas tree. Like,
you smells so good.
You do what they do in the office, and that's when you put those fake pine tree things you have in a car, and then you put it in the fake Christmas tree. If someone were to get a real tree, how much is a real tree?
You know, I don't know. I thought I read somewhere where the average tree is about $80. Average real tree is about $80, which was more than I would have guessed.
Yeah.
And more than you want to pay for every year.
Artificial trees, if you don't buy them on sale, are upwards of $200, $300, $400, $500. Like, they're expensive.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Absolutely. But the thing is, you keep those trees for forever then.
Yeah, here's the thing. The other problem I have with them is most artificial trees now come with the lights attached.
Yeah.
Right. In fact, I don't know if any come with them unattached now. What happens if they burn out? You have to pitch the whole thing, right? With a real tree.
You just put more lights on them.
No, but like if there's a short in the cord or something and the middle, you know, the middle 40% of the tree doesn't work, well, that's going to look like junk. You have to pitch it out. That's why I like another reason I like a real tree is like then you get to put your own lights on it. You can change it up. Like, you can
start a fire in your house. It's fine.
Yeah, exactly. Christmas. Yeah, you can't, because there's so many safety warnings you have to do with real trees. Like, you can't have them face light, and you have to make sure that you don't have anything real around it, and you can't put any presents that might cause a fire, and that you have to have a fire extinguisher next to the tree. And
what if a squirrel like a accidentally comes in?
What?
What if a squirrel accidentally comes in with it?
Exactly. You have to make sure that there's no animals in the tree, and so that is
amazing.
How would that be amazing?
Have you not seen Christmas Vacation, Jerry? I know you love that movie. All right. So, destinations for Christmas, warm or cold?
Cold. Cold.
Well, it's different for us because, like, we live where it's usually cold for Christmas. Right. Like, why would you need to go somewhere else that's cold? Like, if you're going to leave, I'd go somewhere warm, but...
So you're like the majority. I looked this up, and of the top 10 most popular destinations, 9 of the 10 are warm climates. The only cold climate was New York. And in this area of the country, like for me, I want a white Christmas. Not only do I want it cold, I want snow. And it's weird. I remember there was one Christmas we spent in Houston, and it was strange being like able to go out in shorts for Christmas. It just didn't feel like Christmas.
It's weird. Yep, I agree.
Yeah. Oh man, no, I gotta have snow. There has to be snow on the ground. Snow has to be coming down on Christmas. No, I prefer cold destinations for the holidays. Maybe afterwards, maybe Christmas when Christmas is over, let's go someplace warm. Maybe it's Christmas vacation, but Christmas you're around family. I'm cold weather. I'm white Christmas all day.
Yep. All right, guys, I've got a trivia for you.
Oh, gosh.
Okay. Cue up the Christmas music. Let's
trivia
go.
Time.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Better win this freaking
thing. I'm glad you guys sang that. We won't have to put the song in there and then get a copyright notice. True. So this is a little bit shorter. Three questions each. We do have a tiebreaker. I hope we get to do the tiebreaker. Rusty, you won the contest to see who goes first. So your question, and these are all, most of these are 50-50. So you could win by just being lucky.
Okay.
What percent of Americans, we talked about fake Christmas trees. What percent of Americans use a fake Christmas tree? Is it above or below 80%?
I'm going to go below.
It is above.
Son of a B.
82% of Americans have a fake Christmas tree.
I would have said below. I would have said below.
Congratulations on your victory, Jarett.
Well, let's calm down. We're one question in, okay?
Jarett, what percent of Americans celebrate Christmas? 80 or 90%?
I'll say 80%.
All right, we're 0-2.
Wow.
90% of Americans, 90% of Americans celebrate Christmas. Which makes me feel more comfortable about our discussion earlier of using Merry Christmas versus Happy Holidays. Statistically, you're pretty safe using Merry Christmas. Rusty.
Wow. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Believe it or not, Christmas decorating can be a little bit dangerous. How many ER visits are due to Christmas decorating each year? 500, 5,000, or 15,000?
I'm going to go high. Let's go 15,000.
That's correct.
Yes.
We got one.
Just shy of 15,000 ER visits every year for trying to reach that tip-top peak of the house to get those lights up.
Buy your Aflac accident insurance.
Guys, there you go. There you go. Aflac.
Aflac.
Jarett, to tie this back up.
Okay.
On the topic of Christmas trees, dried Christmas trees cause more or less than 200 fires a year in the U.S.
Oh, I would have to say more.
It's actually less.
Whoa!
So you guys had this huge concern earlier in our episode about the dangers of Christmas trees. It's only about 100 fires every year are caused from a dry Christmas tree. Rusty, back to you. So we talked about ER visits, right? Are there, which there were roughly about 15,000. Are there more or less lights on the Rockefeller Center Christmas tree?
Oh man, that is a big tree, which is also where they find Kevin in Home Alone 2.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
I am going to say more.
There are 25,000 lights on the Rockefeller Christmas tree.
Two? Oh, okay.
Jarett, this is for 2 points.
Okay.
What?
Well, this is not a multiple choice.
He wants to have a tiebreaker question.
This is not a multiple choice question either, so this is a little more difficult. 2-0. Jarett, Jingle Bells was actually originally written for another holiday. What holiday was it for?
Jingle Bells. Jingle bell. Is the hint in the song at all?
Well, first off, that's not Jingle Bell.
It's not.
How does
Jingle Bells go all the way?
I'll say, I'm going to take a guess. I'll say Valentine's Day.
Unfortunately, that's the incorrect answer. It was written for Thanksgiving.
Come on. It's real close to Christmas.
How that makes no sense.
It pays to educate yourself.
It does.
Jeez. Okay. Wow.
All right. Tiebreaker question. Yeah. Tiebreaker question just for fun. Rusty wins. Rusty, okay. Kudos. Congratulations. Tiebreaker question for fun and for our listeners. How many kids does Santa deliver presents to on Christmas around the world? And we're going to assume that he delivers to all the kids that are under 14 years old.
And on the nice list.
And the three of us. How many people, aren't there like 8 billion people in the world?
There are 8 billion people in the world.
Okay.
So you have that
number to go from.
8 billion. Now, people who celebrate Christmas and people under the age of 14.
And the three of us.
I will say, I'll just take a guess. I'll say 900 million and three.
Okay. Rusty?
I'm going to go with 1.1 billion and three.
Jarett's the closest. It's actually 526 million and three.
Dang, it's half a billion.
Yep, half a billion. So before we wrap up, we also have a few more videos coming up. So if you haven't seen our spicy gummy challenge, check that out. Rusty gets destroyed.
Oh my gosh.
We have a few more spicy challenges and then another little challenge that we did. So be on the lookout for those in the coming weeks as well.
Yeah. One of my favorite videos of all time. Check it out. Rusty eating a hot gummy worm. Amazing. Amazing. It's the next Citizen Kane. It's what it is.
I'm an idiot.
So to everyone, Merry Christmas. Thank you all for listening. We hope you have a wonderful time with your family and friends, and we'll catch you all after Christmas.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful. And to play that as we're going, and the fire is so delightful. But as long as we got no place to go,
let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Yes, nailed it.
Not exactly experts, signing out.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.